Welcome back to Watching the Newsroom. Now, this is a special discussion we are having between two very important voices in the lending space, in the financial market space. One of the foremost public sector banks, BOB, and the other, which is a very fast rising tech-enabled lending platform, particularly aimed at SME universe, and that is led by Mr. Sachindranath, YouGrow Capital. Of course, the occasion is that both of them have come together and done a pact for co-lending operations. So both of the representatives are joining us, Mr. Khichi from Bank of Baroda and Mr. Sachindranath from YouGrow Capital. Gentlemen, thank you so much for chatting with us and coming on my show. Mr. Sachindranath, congratulations on this development. You've been just started the company 2-3 years back, if I'm not wrong, and it is moving from one milestone to the other. Talk to us about why this tie-up is a very meaningful one, and how does it help you to achieve the objectives that you've set for the bank?
Yeah, thank you. It's not just for YouGrow. Actually, the co-lending as a format of business for the entire NBFC industry is very critical. As you know, that post IL&FS crisis and for multiple other reasons, the liquidity which have been available for NBFCs historically got shrunk dramatically. Reserve Bank of India, both in 2018 and then in 2020, designed a framework of co-lending between the banks and the NBFC. The purpose of the entire scheme of things, that as you know, that banks have control over liquidity because they command the trust of the retail savings investor, and NBFCs have access to the last mile. Historically, most of the NBFC have been just borrowing from the banks and lending to the underserved market. But this scheme allows bank to have granular view of every loan which is being disbursed, and the partnership is a partnership of two sets of financial institutions who have their requisite skill set. NBFCs which have the they can originate, they can underwrite, they can disburse, and banks provide the liquidity. My view is obviously for YouGrow, we are very privileged that, you know, the bank, a large public sector bank like Bank of Baroda, has not only assessed our underwriting parameters, our entire framework, and it has, you know, done diligence on us for the last 1 year or so, and it would provide the required impetus for our mission to serve the underserved market of MSME. But we believe that not only for YouGrow, for the entire lending fraternity of NBFC, this would be a milestone, and most of the NBFC will very soon follow the steps of this, and co-lending would become the mainstay of the liability side spectrum for NBFCs.
Right. Fair point. In fact, you gave me a hint for my next question to Mr. Khichi, who's also joining us, the V.S. Khichi, Executive Director at Bank of Baroda. Sir, good afternoon to you as well. Talk to us about how this entire arrangement is taking off. Of course, YouGrow Capital is the latest one, but you have done similar arrangements with other NBFCs as well. How this particular arrangement or the model of lending is taking off? You have decades of observation as far as the entire lending space is concerned. How do you see the progress of this particular model?
Adesh, to answer that question, I'll just take a step back, and maybe in one of those 18 now programs only, I think it was empowering the ecosystem, where I had been actually asked for my opinion that what would be the future for MSME lending would be. And I remember very distinctly having said that I think co-origination, co-sourcing, co-lending would be the model that we would be looking for going forward, and that would be one of the most elegant and efficient manners of MSME lending per se. So since then, we were actually working on this particular aspect, and in terms of the RBI circular 2018, we were working with on co-lending agenda, but somehow there were many challenges which were actually faced, and then came an enabler in terms of RBI circular, I think it was November 2020, which gave a little bit more elbow room and a flexibility into co-lending, and that is the time when we actually partnered with YouGrow Capital and a few more NBFCs, small NBFCs, and we started building up something which we could actually find it sustainable, and we could build up the skills. I mean, this was a scalable model that we were looking, and we found that unless and until this is done in a very efficient digital manner, it may not actually take off or be found sustainable. And since then, I think it's almost 5-6 months that both the teams from UGRO and BOB, they have been working together in finding solutions to every problem. And I must tell you that this has been a pretty challenging task for us. There will be lots of issues in terms of maybe the policies, the practices, the regulations which differentiate between the banks and the NBFCs in terms of all, maybe the origination, maybe the assessment and the underwriting, and maybe the maintenance part of it. To elaborate, it may be the accounting systems, it may be the IREC norms and all, and matching them, coming on a common platform was pretty challenging, but I'm very happy that now it is behind us, and almost 90% of entire platform has been laid. The fine tuning of that is still underway, but I'm happy that it has finally arrived.
Right. Mr. Sachindranath, talk to us about how you are going about, for your business of lending on the tech platform for SMEs, because that is really the real India which is in need of capital, especially be it working capital, be it term loans, in order to keep their business and grow their business. And they also got very badly affected in the last 4 to 6 quarters. How differently are you aiming at that opportunity, because there is a very high competition after all there. A lot of companies are in the fray to do the same. Some are private equity backed, very strong capital backed. So the only way to differentiate yourself is the processes. How are your processes different?
Yeah, Ajit, I think it's half glass full, half glass empty situation, because as you're saying that there are lot many players who are coming in and there is very, very large competition. But simultaneously, as you know, that 35% plus GDP of India is contributed by MSMEs. Roughly around 11 crore people are employed with SMEs, and the credit gap for SMEs in India is a staggering $600 billion. So while you may say that there are too many players, but the fact is that the amount of under-penetration of credit for SME, I don't think so that in the next decade or so we can fulfill. There is a need for at least 50 or 100 more new players to come and fill that gap. So that's the size of the need or the requirement is. Second, UGRO's aspiration have been to build India's largest small business financing platform. What we have seen over a period of time that to solve the problem of the credit for SME, you need to deeply understand and differentiate between one type of SME customer to other type of SME customer. Now, to do that by only using people is a very difficult task, and that's why we use what we call the data, the process and the analytical technology, and a very large physical footprint supplementing those three. Our view is that in next 3 years, a small business financing in India would reach to the same stage where the consumer financing is. Because the emergence of the data stack which is now getting developed. So if you look at the combination of three things, GST, banking and bureau, and the OCEN network and the India stack too, we would be able to finance every small business on a click of a button. I think so. It looks like a dream today, but take my words, it's just a matter of time how this would evolve. Second, I think so, the small business financing in India has been predominantly driven by collateral, versus the need is predominantly in the cash flow based financing. UGRO has designed itself to capture or service both market. We have a large branch led channel which does secured and unsecured financing. We have an ecosystem channel which does supply chain and machinery. We have a digital channel, and we have a partnership and alliance channel wherein we ride upon the transaction flow of any underlying partner. It can be a payment bank, it can be a market aggregator, it can be a small NBFC, so on and so forth. Idea is to combine the conventional knowledge of underwriting an SME customer and digitize and use data analytics and technological process flow. And that's a journey. It will take another 2 to 3 years. But anyone who uses this combination of these two would definitely be able to serve this market. One of the reasons why, you know, large banks and their knowledge set of seeing, you know, SME business for almost 3 decades and plus, understand the innovation which we are bringing for them. And that's why these kind of collaboration would accelerate, because unlike banks, NBFC can do all kind of innovation on the asset side front, on the origination, the customer service. But if you have, you can have a line of liquidity which comes from the large bank, we should be able to serve this market over a period of next 3 to 5 years.
Right. All right. Before we wrap out, a very quick word from Mr. Geechee. Sir, can you help us? I won't talk anything about the bank, but just want to understand from your vantage point, how do you see the demand for credit comeback going forward, especially now that we are unlocking in rest of the country gradually, and also the festive season lies ahead. A lot of corporates we speak to of all shapes and sizes are also talking about the capex, the buzzword is coming back. Do you see credit demand improve meaningfully in the next 3-4 quarters?
Mr. Ajay, I do agree with that in entirety. In fact, all the indicators that are coming for July are on the positive side. And though MSME sector per se has been the one which has suffered the most, but nevertheless, I am absolutely hopeful and optimistic that going forward, I think as the indicators are suggesting, maybe the Q2 by Q2 end, I think we should be looking in the positive territory. I think that the things should be looking bright. The worst should be over behind us.
All right. On that positive and optimistic note, to Mr. Geechee and Mr. Sachidananath, I would thank both of you for joining on the show today. With that, it's a wrap on the show. Thanks very much for watching. Goodbye.